Hello, and welcome! Silrace here with War Thunder Ground Forces! American tanks have been released. Well, they were released a couple days ago already, but I was busy playing them instead of making videos of them, unfortunately. Something like that. Anyway, let's talk briefly about some tanks and whatnot, and how am I having fun with War Thunder Ground Forces again. Anyway. So, American tanks are interesting because you suddenly have machine guns, you have multiple guns on these things, you have a rotating turret and you have a stationary gun essentially, and then you have machine guns you can try to shoot the planes with. All sorts of funky things like this, which is kind of nice and nifty, especially since, especially at the low tires, you can use the machine guns to actually destroy hostile tanks too. Like, you can shoot them in the rear, you're doing some random damage, and I remember setting someone on fire with the machine gun, that was hilarious. Of course, I have some massive issues with the game as well, because, well, for example, artillery happens to be a... Well, artillery which is not on the map as a vehicle, like, you have to, don't have to drive it. In World of Tanks, obviously, everyone hates artillery, but in World of Tanks, I can go and kill the hostile artillery. It is a piece on the board, so to say. Here it isn't. Here it just, you know, you just rain artillery. Anyway, and you hostiles cannot do anything but hope that they get out of it in time. And don't get killed or hit by it. Anyway. The American tanks... The low-tier tanks have always this issue, at least I do have this always this issue with the game, with the having to research parts first so I can even repair the thing, which is annoying, but the fact that they skid around like a speedboat on an ocean or a lake, instead of like driving like they were on the ground, is a little bit annoying, especially since you happen to collide with a random rock by accident, and then knock out your driver and it takes like 10 seconds for a driver to be back up so you can continue driving. And, well, I have actually also crashed into a building by accident because someone, like, collided with the rear of my tank, so I veered off course and, you know, collided with a wall and my whole crew got knocked out and I lost the tank. And that was very interesting. Thankfully, towing cables are now in the game, so if you happen to flip the tank over, because apparently it is easier to flip a tank over than it is to flip a freaking speedboat over. Anyway, if you happen to flip your tank over, you can, you know, ask someone to help, you know, pull you back up, right? As soon as someone even notices, oh, someone is asking for help. Anyway. The game is kind of fun again, from the point of view that there are new tanks to play. And also, the kill cam is really, really nifty. Obviously, the fact that it exists in, like, realistic and, well, maybe not so much realistic, but it also exists in the simulator mode, which is kinda weird. Like, I shouldn't be able to see this freaking cam if I am firing at things in the simulator mode. That makes no sense whatsoever. But, as for the game itself, the fact that there is, like, a one-shot kill, it kind of deters people from actually playing the objective of the game, because usually you have a cap point, right? When you're playing Ground Forces, you have a cap point. So you go and cap the point, you drive towards there, and someone from the distance just blows you up, because you are the one going for the cap point, the other guy is camping at the far back, because that's what you do if you want kills in this game. You camp a little bit away from the cap point, you wait for some idiot to try to cap the point, and you shoot them and blow them up, and you rack up the kills. So you can get this kill streak of a bomber plane with 20 bombs and bomb the rest of their team to back to the Stone Age. That was a bit of a rant, wasn't it? Anyway, because I find this whole kill streak bomber plane thing a little silly, and I will make a specific video talking about the artillery and well, bomber plane, fighter plane changes I would like to see very near in the future, or rather soon, or I would like to see them change. But as for the gameplay with the tanks themselves, I'm enjoying it in the sense that you're actually rewarded for not simply taking snapshots. Granted, if you do a snapshot, you hit some part of the tank, you get a reward, lions and XP and research points and all that stuff. But if you manage to you know, be the guy who doesn't take the snapshot, so you're in the reload, so you can actually, you actually aim your shot and kill the hostile tank in one hit. That is awesome, right? I like that. That is fun. However, it does generate this whole, like, let's not play the objective, because freaking say we could be killed by playing the objective. By hanging back, you know, from the objective, so the hostiles get to the objective and come, it's my objective, I'm watching it, and then you blow up everyone who happens to be on the objective. Background footage, by the way, is obviously arcade game mode, because this is recorded, well, when I was still getting used to the controls again. I hadn't played for a while, so I had to get used to the tanks and the controls. First time playing USA tanks, like most everyone anyway. Game is obviously, like most games such as this, are obviously so much more fun when you are doing it with a friend and not just randomly solo grinding your way through the low tire tanks. So yeah. Low tire tanks are hilarious though, in the sense that you just skid all over the place and do the stupidest things in them. And I don't know, somehow you are supposed to be able to kill the hostiles while you're doing all that. Anyway. Thank you very much for watching War Thunder Ground Forces rant, introduction to the USA tanks, and whatever else this video was. Mostly just me rambling, because I had some fun playing the game again. I'll probably put some more hours into it and maybe make a couple more videos. Definitely make one video about the bomber plane and the artillery strikes again. As said, thank you very, very much for watching.